What's up, guys? It's your favorite twins, and a lot of music has been released recently. Yes. A lot. One of the recent releases has been Lil Nas X and Jack Harlow's Industry Baby. As soon as I heard about this collaboration, I was instantly intrigued because I've watched both of their careers pretty closely, and they both have this don't give a fuck attitude about people's opinions. Like the way that Jack carries himself on social media, he says the most outlandish
things. He's such a troll, yeah.
And obviously we've seen Lil Nas X, you know, break barriers just by being himself. Him continuing to do that and seeing them come together, I feel like it just made sense.
Honestly, when I first heard that they were collaborating, it's two people that I didn't expect to get together. Mm-hmm. So I was a little bit thrown off, but also very intrigued because, like you said, they do have different brands and the way they, I guess, they go about their artistry.
Their approaches, yeah.
And their approaches, but I think that's what made me so intrigued. Because it's when you take two completely different artists and you bring them together, it's very interesting to see what they're going to create.
Exactly. And this is Jack coming into Nas's world.
Yeah.
So I'm interested to see that as well. I'm not sure if this video is going to be on the same level as some of the other visuals have been.
I heard some
talk.
I did.
So,
I mean, again, although we may not react to everything, we do see and hear everything.
Musically, though, I don't know what direction they're headed in. I heard a little bit of the beat, but they're two of my favorite hip-hop artists right now as well. They're kind of on that rise together in a way, you know? Yeah. So I'm excited to see this.
Lil Nas X, I sentenced you to 5 years in Montero State Prison.
Okay. Montero State Prison. Baby, bet. Hey, Cooper X. Oh. Couple Grammys on your couple packs. Yeah. That's a bet. Hey, throw it back. Oh. Throw it back. And he's one is on a champion. And you lost his time in jail. Funny how you said he was a yeah. You know, we did it again. I told you long ago. Oh, my goodness. Okay, all right.
I
like it.
I
was that supposed to represent dropping the soap when it went around?
Supposed to represent dropping the soap.
Off all that. Right,
all right.
The accents of pink. I already know where it feels a little bit like a continuation of
Montero Jail.
Wow. Call Me by Your Name.
How interesting.
The pink. Remember how he was in pink in the video?
Yeah.
And was being stoned?
Yeah.
And now we're kind of it's almost like they're all in there for the same thing.
We're 42 seconds into the video.
Where are we going? I like the transformation though with the tattoos and everything. 3 months later.
Yeah, yeah. How he went from,
this motherfucker.
Yeah, yeah. And is it burns on his face or
what? Cuts.
Cuts? Interesting. Let's keep
Could
watching.
Could that sort of represent his career?
What do you mean?
How hard his career has been so far?
Could be.
I mean, I'm sure it's just the aesthetic of jail, but it's called Industry Baby. So is it
the scars? Interesting.
Oh, let's keep watching.
Yeah. Dog, get your soul, just
telling me laying low. It's cool. You was never really rooting for me anyway. Yeah. When I'm back up at the top, I want to hear you say, you don't run from nothing, dog, get your soul. Outside.
Hey! Is that? Oh, I swore that was Jason Momoa?
Yes, Aquaman is in Montero Prison.
It just looked like him for a second.
I could see that.
I didn't know if they were going to be star
cameos. He said he needed a hit with Nicki now. Facts.
Yeah.
Facts.
Yeah.
And that's another thing I saw. Y'all gonna stop. This man has looked up to Nicki for a very long time.
He's
allowed
to
mention her however many times he wants to.
He's looked up to her for a long time.
But he said he a pop nigga like Bieber. That's facts.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like that because it's showing how hip-hop has has become the most popular genre in
it
the
really
world.
Has.
Like,
it
hip-hop
really has.
Is the new pop.
Hip-hop is pop. Yeah.
Yeah.
Seriously.
On
for a bitch, I'm queer.
Hey! He said y'all bitches like Madea. I like that little ding.
Yeah.
I got Jack in there too. Everybody trying to sue me. You call me Nas, but your hood call me Doobie. Oh, did you peep? That's a performance. It's almost like that's what he's in there for. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
his career is why he's obviously why he's in there.
Interesting. Okay.
Escape.
Okay.
This part's very catchy.
Yes. Ow. Get your soul.
And he's watching the video.
Colin Haynes!
Oh shit.
Where is his eyebrows at?
Yeah.
That's Colin though. Wait, that's nice. He got fucked up.
Yeah, he did.
He ain't got totally messed sneakers. Up.
Oh, the
I like to see his details
it's
like that.
It's details like that. I like that. Wow, you had a good eye. I didn't realize that was Colin at first.
Can I do this? I do this.
Shout out to Arrow. Just shout out to Arrow.
And Team Wolf. My track record so clean, they couldn't wait to just bash me. I must be getting too flashy, y'all shouldn't have let the world gas me. It's too late, cause I'm here to stay, and these girls know that I'm nasty. I sent it back to her boyfriend with my hand in front of her ass. City talk.
Nah, we gotta go back.
Man, that was hard.
I sent it back to her boyfriend with my
hand. Oh, look at his hand, look at his handprint. City talking, we taking notes. Hey. Tell him all to keep making posts, wish he could, but he can't get close. OG's so proud of me that he choking up while he making toast. Hey. I'm the type that you can't control, said I would, then I made it so. I don't clear up rumors, hey. Where's y'all sense of humor? I'm making jokes cause they got old like baby. That's cool. My haters to consumers, I make vets feel like they juniors.
That's
nice. Say your time is coming soon, but just like Oklahoma. Mine is coming sooner, I'm just a late bloomer. Oh, you did escape, okay.
Yeah.
I'm still out here getting cuter. All these social networks and computers got these pussies walking around like they ain't losers. I told you. These computers got these pussies walking around like they ain't losers. They was talking to y'all before you even had, they already knew. After this, y'all was gonna have something to say. They already knew.
Yeah.
It was like, they.
Yeah. Yeah. That verse.
That was about. We're gonna look at the lyrics after this.
Yeah. Jack's just got. I like the way he raps. It's very smooth.
Oh, that's working. Hey. Hey.
Did you say?
Hey. So he comes out triumphant. Burn that shit down. Yup.
Yup. I like that.
Nah, that was dope. That was dope.
Wow.
I like that. That was dope. As himself. Yeah. That was dope.
That was another a good hit. Video.
Another banger.
That was a good video.
Yeah. And song. Alright, so let's take a look at the lyrics now. Let's see these lyrics. I told you long ago on the road, I got what they waiting for. I don't run from nothing, dog. Get your soul, just tell them I ain't laying low. Overall, I feel like this is a song about defying the odds. Beating people's expectations of you. Even down to the idea of having a straight rapper on this song. And a gay rapper and a straight rapper coming together. Because I feel like you would think artists would be hesitant to collaborate with him.
Of course.
Especially
hetero rappers. Only because of the way that he is setting up his quote-unquote brand.
Yeah.
Which is more so just being comfortable in his skin.
Yeah.
And so that's why I give it up to Jack Harlow, because he didn't let his pride or anything that other people say or any kind of buzz that they put in his ear stop him from working with someone who is equally as talented.
Exactly.
And creative.
Yeah, you know, and they didn't let the fear of people's opinions stop them from creating something great. You know what I mean?
Right.
Because
right.
I feel like when politics infiltrate art, it becomes a real problem for me, at least.
Yeah.
You know, when you start to look at things that shouldn't matter, it can keep you from things like this.
Exactly.
You know, so I'm glad that on both of their parts, there was a willingness to work together. They're peers, you know what I mean? They're peers at the end of the day. They're in this industry together, they're coming up together. So it's nice to see them side by side, doing what they do best, which is rapping, making music. It looks like they had fun on set. The concept of the video, I feel like, is something that they can both relate to at the same time.
I was actually gonna touch on that. I was trying to figure out, I didn't understand the lyrics for the chorus, even though it was really catchy, so I was going based off the melody.
Mm-hmm.
But now that I look at it, and the reason why it's called Industry Baby, I think it's called Industry Baby because of how you start off in the industry.
Mm.
And how they mold you.
Yeah.
How they... So you are literally the industry's baby. You are the industry's product.
That, or you come into the industry as a baby and
not knowing.
Yeah, not knowing. And learning yourself, growing, and, you know, having to experience all these things for the first time.
Right, so when I look at, like, I told you long ago, On the Road, to me, that's like an ode
to Old Town Road. Yep.
And how when he first came out, he said he really had to hide his more so feminine side.
Yeah.
You know, need to get this album done, need a couple number ones, need a black on every song, maybe one like with Nicki now. It just, I like
the boastful
aspect
too, because he's got a right to boast. I mean, he's had a very successful career so far.
So far, with a little bit of songs that he's released.
But it's also the opposition.
Yes, yes.
Y'all have to understand that he is in a genre. This is hip hop.
This is hip hop, man.
Okay, if you are familiar with hip hop, then you know that hip hop is not only a male dominated genre, but straight, hetero. Like, it's very.
And you know what?
Not accepting.
And I hope this doesn't come off the wrong way, but when homosexuality is accepted into the rap industry, it's only with women, it's not men.
I've noticed that too.
But I think it's because most of the time, you know, the women tend, they can carry a bit of a more masculine energy, which I think then makes their male rap peers feel, you know.
Exactly. It's the same way that in the 90s, female rappers had to carry, even if they were straight, had to carry more of a masculine frame.
Exactly.
So it's the fact that he's not only black and gay, but showing that quote unquote feminine side.
Yeah.
It's important because hip-hop has for such a long time been one way. I'm excited that he's pushing this envelope because it's gonna allow, you know, the industry to usher in new artists that are gonna be able to, you know, do things like this and have the room to do it. So you, at the end of the day, you have to give him his respect. The fact that he's pushing these boundaries and he's keeps coming back, because after, you know, Call Me By Your Name,
you really do sit there and wonder what next.
Not even just what next, he could have very easily said, I'm not going to do something like that again. I'm not going to push envelope again.
Because of all the backlash.
Exactly.
Of all the backlash.
He could have easily been over, as someone said.
Even with the Nike scandal, as embarrassing as
that was. He said in the song, he's like, now they want to sue me.
Yeah, as embarrassing as that might have been, he used it to his advantage. What I do want to say, because there were a lot of tweets talking about having Harlow on the song as a heterosexual man, a lot of people were mad that Jack was having intimate scenes with a woman. However, I like how Jack cleared it up and said that when Nas presented the storyboard to him, it was basically given. But if Nas had said, hey, join me in the shower scene, Jack would have gladly done it. So I like how they kind of squashed all of that and said it's not that Jack was uncomfortable.
Yeah.
It's not that Jack didn't want to do it. It's not that Jack had a preference. It was what was brought to Jack, and Jack went along with it, and they made it their own.
I feel like the video was constructed right, because it's almost like Jack played his part.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, in that shower scene, everybody was black. And I just want to say that, like...
Could you imagine having an awkward naked white man?
It's just like, I feel like things were constructed the way that they were supposed to be, like, to get the message across.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That scene was what came across to me. I could be wrong. It was a celebration of black gay men being proud.
Of course.
Dancing, taking up the entire room, the entire space, and being comfortable in that space.
Absolutely.
So, it just wasn't necessary. And that's my thing. Y'all always
people
find
look for
something
unnecessary
to be
things.
Y'all always find something to be mad about.
Like, if you think it's too risky, if you think it's too improper, just... Don't watch it.
And don't talk about it either. Because I never understood how someone could hate something
so
much.
And
it's all you tweet about. Like, you're wasting characters.
I also think it's called Montero State Prison because of, like, self-hatred. And not having an acceptance of self. I think for me, when I heard, like, Montero State Prison, I said, interesting, because that's his first name.
But it's also the world.
That's identity.
It's the name of the album.
Yeah. I mean, there are other, like, you know, artistic things to go along with it. But if we have to look deeper, I think that could be
some people struggle with that.
Looking at the
lyrics. I loved Jack's bar.
I sent it back to my wife with my handprint on her ass.
It's just the animation of even that. Like, they brought the same energy. They really carried this track. The instrumental is hard. Them horns in the beginning.
The instrumental's hard as well.
Are triumphant. That's why I said when he went out at the end, breaking out of that.
Yeah,
if I were
bringing
to,
everybody with him. Yeah.
See what I'm saying? Yeah. And that could represent him breaking those barriers. Breaking out of that. Because even with the idea of a prison, it could also be a mental state.
But that's
it
what I mean by Montero.
It'd be an idea of, like, breaking out of self-limiting beliefs.
Yes.
And sometimes you can be your own prison. Your mind can be that prison. And, you know, if he were to give into that prison, he wouldn't take the risk that he's taking. He wouldn't say the things that he's saying.
Yeah.
And so I'm glad to see that these kinds of visuals and these kinds of songs and these kinds of moments are becoming normalized.
Yeah. Overall, great video, and a great song. Yes. I think it's another banger. If this is on its way to number one, I get it. I get it, Nas. You keep doing it.
And let me also say this. I'm sorry to do that to you. Another thing that I really liked is... It was linked with a fundraiser for the Bell X Fund. So I thought that was really special as well, because that's what I'm saying. If you're hating on this, you are just...
You're not seeing the message.
If you have a problem with this, just admit that you're a hater and we don't have to fight.
Yeah.
Just admit it and it's fine.
That's it.
You know, one thing to have an opinion, but if you hate this, like, you're a hater and it's all right.
It's okay.
You know, everyone's entitled to their wrong opinion. But I think what he's doing is really special and it's to be commended, whether you agree with some of the things or not.
If you enjoyed the video and the song, let us know down below in the comments. We'd love to know your thoughts.
If you enjoyed watching us react, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on those post notifications, that way you know when we upload, and we'll catch you guys on the next one.